My country people, I salute you all. I am not happy at all, you know, with the way our country is going. Those of us who think that separation is the only option to solve this problem in Nigeria, they call us names. They said we are preaching hate speech. But look, Nigeria today, monkey they walk by body shop, killings every day, killing people as if they are killing rats. Look at Adamawa. These people, they kill themselves. People kill people as if and they are deriving pleasure from killing people. Killing people make them happy. And you share the same country with such people. When you share the same country with people who think killing is the only way they please God, or the killings is killing their fellow human being is the only way they will feel good. When you share the same country with people like that, there is no way you have peace in that country. It must be kata kata. I don't want to talk about Edo State Governor. You know, that one is building more prison now. They are expanding the Oko prison, the White House in Benin, because the place have been filled up. They are taking prisoners to Aunshi now, you know, because they have another prison in Aunshi. Set up the governor to, you know, create a job for the youth, but they are building more prison, sending people to prison. I have been saying this for a very long time now. I said Edo State Governor is building more prison, sending people to prison. No, nobody is listening. You know, sometimes I don't understand APC. We all know that, people like us, we know that Buhari will fail. Because we know that Buhari is a serial failure. Buhari will fail. But nobody would have believed that it would be like this. Even those of us who know that Buhari will definitely fail don't know it will be as bad as the way things are. Nobody will believe things will be bad like this. That's just the truth. Nobody would have... There's no way you would believe, because the way they were campaigning, the way they were presenting themselves, the way they were saying it, we know that people like us, we know that they are going to fail. They are not going to do these things they promise, but not as fail the way it is now, the way things are going now. So nasty. The moment a professor, a learned person, professor, become APC member, that is the very day become stupid. Yes, can't you see learned people before? People like Adesina, Femi Adesina, before he joined these APC gangs. This man was bright when he was doing this press thing, when he was working under this, you know. The man was bright. We saw future, bright future. When he wrote that, what they call it. But look at Adesina today. Adesina is finished. Look at people like Joe Igbokwe. Look at Joe Igbokwe. Joe Igbokwe, a learned man. When you see him talking, you know that yes, that man is finished. We even have a pastor, a professor as a vice president. And look at the way, look at how things are going in our country. Let every region go down separate way. They said, no, we must die together by force. It's so painful. But what I'm here to talk about is the nonsense that I'm hearing. The nonsense I saw on television today. The federal government of Nigeria petitioned Italian government demanding explanation over the hasty burial of 26 teenage girls who were trekking to Europe, who died on the Mediterranean Sea. They're drawn where they are trying to cross to Europe. Our government have the mind, have the guts, the effrontery, asking if the Italian government why they buried them in haste. Charlie. Even The president of Nigeria is a Muslim. The day Muslim die is the day they bury them. Now, they are trying to fool themselves, because they always fool themselves, telling the Italian government, why did they bury them? Our Islamic federal government of Nigeria demanding explanation from Italian government over the hasty burial of 26 teenage girls who died on the Mediterranean Sea trying to cross to Europe. Can you imagine? When I saw this thing on television today, it scattered my brain. First of all, I say APC again. When will these people change? When a professor become a PC member, that is the very day a professor become a PC member, he become foolish. A doctor become a PC member, he become stupid. A banker become a PC member, he become stupid. Become useless. What of the one they are asking now, why did they bury them? What of the Nigerians dying, they are killing in South Africa? Why the federal government is not saying anything about that? Why the federal government did not petition South Africa government that they are killing Nigerians there? The xenophobia that is going on in South Africa. Why? My people, let's ask ourselves this question. Why? People are being sold in Libya. Nigerians are being sold in Libya. They are selling Nigerians, selling blacks. Not only Nigeria, but they are 60% of the blacks they are selling in Libya. They are from Nigeria. They are selling them there. They are selling them. And the government is not doing anything about it. And this idiot think they have the guts, they have the effort to be petitioning, to asking the Italian government why they bury these people. Italian government just help us in burying these people, buying caskets. They help us burying these people. They did not kill these people. They are not the one that killed them. Things were hard in Nigeria, in their own country. They tried to cross over. They died on the Mediterranean Sea. When they discovered the dead body, it was all over international news. Every international news, they were all televising, they were all saying it. Now, the stupid Nigerian and the president, they kept quiet. They kept quiet. Now they see that they have been buried. It became a shame to them. This is the language of a bad government. This is a proof that Nigeria, we don't have a government. We don't have government. We don't have president. President who talk nonsense all the time. What a shame. I don't think they want money from the Italian government. Because that's what they are trying to do now. The Italian government buried them with honor. At least the Italian government buried them with honor. Because Nigerian, when a child died outside, maybe your own son, your own children, maybe one of your child died outside, before people will say, look, who is the father of this person, whatever. The father will say, oh, it's my son or it's my daughter. The father will now go there and go and carry the body. But they have been saying these people are from Nigeria. Nigeria government kept quiet. They did not go. They did not send any plane to Italy to go and say, okay, bring back the dead body. They kept quiet. And about 16 of these girls, they were from Edo State. Our stupid governor, Obaseki, is there celebrating his 1 year. Languishing our money for nothing, inviting international musicians, dancing, celebrating 1 year of foolishness, celebrating Alau madness. Now they feel ashamed of themselves. They are not trying to make noise, telling the Italian government why did they bury these people. They died in the midst of running away from the grave Nigeria. Nigeria is a grave. Nigeria is hell. They died in the midst of running away from her. But so fortunately, they died again. They died on the Mediterranean Sea in search of greener pastures. There is no better way to die. I believe for them, they feel dying of the Mediterranean Sea is better than living in Nigeria, living in abject poverty in Nigeria. That's why these girls ran away. They die risking it all. They die. They risk their life. They know that it is 50-50. So that they die or they survive. Then they because of what they are passing through in Nigeria, they prefer to take that risk. Knowing that there is no possibility that the future will be good for them in Nigeria. If it is where, if these people were from the north, they would have joined the Boko Haram, killing and terrorizing people. Look at what is happening in Adamawa now. These people in the north, I'm not saying all north. We have good and nice people from the north. But these killings is getting too much. Hearing that you are from the country where people kill people as if people mean nothing. It is scary. Every day, go to social media, you see them tearing, massacring young kids. And this year, government is not saying anything about it. What they know is to fight PDP, fight PDP, fight PDP, fight Jonathan, fight Jonathan. It will never be well with Buhari. Never be well with Osinbajo and Co. These foreigners, the Italian, may God continue to bless this country, Italian, bless Italian government. Because they honor these people. After death, they honor them. They use their money to buy a casket for them and give them a befitting burial. Now Nigerian government is making noise. This is a language of a failed government. This is a language of a bad government. The ones killed in South Africa, they are not talking about it. Did they demand the explanation from the South African government? Instead, the Okorocha is building a statue for a South African president. They built a mighty statue to honor him and telling him well done. Stupid set of old people. It will never be well with you people. Thunder that will strike you people is coming your way. If you don't talk, just let these people rest in peace. The Italian government have buried them. Let them be. Then I will not be talking like this. Hypocrisy. You want to do this just to people to say you are good. We know that you are an evil president. You can't keep fooling us like this. When they said these girls, they are from Nigeria, you didn't send plane there to go and bring their body home. Now that these people have buried them with fine casket and people, Italians line up. People that don't line up, Oyibo, they line up, giving them flower. They show that these people are human beings. They know that they take this risk to cross this Red Sea. They are trying to cross Red Sea to come and have a better life here. But our stupid government pretend that they don't know what is going on. The useless Obaseki in Edo State, he was busy celebrating 1 year in office. Dancing Kelewu. Why? Edo children, girls from Edo, dying, drawn, you know, have been buried in another person, in another man's country. Italian government, I praise you people for what you did, for burying these people, giving these girls, these innocent girls, a befitting burial. Nigeria have the mouth, government have the mouth to be questioning these people, telling these people they bury them in haste. When they kill over 130 people in just the other day. Buhari and his wife and his stupid kids, they went to Turkey. Did Buhari buy any casket for these people that they have been killing, or the one they are killing in Adamawana? Did Nigerian government buy? They buried them mass burial. They don't buy anything for them. They just dig holes and put these people there, tie them with white cloth, and just bury them like that. You have the man to be saying you are questioning Italian government. You should be ashamed of yourself. If Nigeria is a country, will your people will be running away every day? Will your young youth did not be joining the Boko Haram every day? The thunderstorm will fire. Thunder will fire Buhari and this APC gangs. Now you people are total hypocrites. You don't even care about the living, about the Nigerians at all. They are asking after the dead. You don't even care about the livings. How the Fulani expert killing people in Jos, killing people in Kaduna, killing people in Adamawa, killing people in Borno. They are killing the livings there, oppressing the livings there. Now you want to ask about the dead, just for these international people to say yes, you are doing good. Useless and stupid president. After the barrier. Now you want to talk. What Nigeria did, Italian government did Nigeria a favor. They should be thanking them. They should be thanking them. Who care about these girls? Nobody care about them. Even their stupid governor, Obaseki from Edo State, did not even make a speech to the evil saying, I don't know. This is a shame. The Italian buried these dead girls, these girls, out of sympathy. They buried them on sympathy and concern of humanity. I was moved to see white people kissing the coffin and mourning on no dead girls, people they don't know. I shook my head when I listened to their president advisor. When I listen to the president advisor, Debre Arewa state that the three confirmed Nigerians, they were wanted autopsy to confirm the identity. It's a disgrace. Nigerian government should be ashamed of themselves. I've never seen a political party so confused like APC. You can understand them. They lie every day. My people, let us unite. Youth, yesterday I was watching an elderly woman, a woman of about 77 to 80 years. He was begging Nigerian youth. I believe she must have watched this 36 girls who died on the Mediterranean Sea. She were begging Nigerian youth to wise up, to take this leadership, Nigerian leadership, to fight these old and useless people like Obasanjo and Buhari and take power from them. She was begging 70 to 80 years old woman. Time for the youth to wake up and realize to be wise. Thank you. I'm the Wonder Civilian. Bye.